Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Today's topic in orthodontics is growth spurts. So growth spurts is nothing but a period where the growth is happening at a very fast manner, or there is an increased or sudden increase in the growth. Okay, so last session we had seen Scammon's growth curves, the lymphoid tissues, the neural tissue, the S-shaped general or somatic tissue, and the genital tissues. So none of these curves are linear. It is not a linear curve. It is having an exponential phase, then a flat phase, then a decreasing phase. So not all the tissue or the tissues are not going in a same growth rate. Sometimes it is having a very exponential growth. Sometimes it is very flat. Sometimes it is in a decreasing fashion. So when there is an increased growth rate, those periods are known as growth spurts. So we have in a person's life three growth spurts. So we can divide it as infantile or childhood growth rate, growth spurts, or mixed dentition or juvenile growth spurt, and the adolescent growth spurt. So the infantile or childhood, we know the babies, they grow very fast. Up to 3 years, their growth rate is very exponentially happening. And the next one is mixed dentition or juvenile phases. The early schooling time, that is maybe the second standard, third standard. So those period, we suddenly gain height. Maybe weight is subjectable, but the height gain is a very common thing. But the thing is, usually the growth spurt is early in females, that is 7 to 9 years, whereas the boys, it is little late, 8 to 11 years. And the next growth spurt is seen in adolescent period. Similarly, it is early in girls, that is 10 to 12 years, and 12 to 14 years in boys. So here also we gain height and weight. So this growth spurt lasts for 2 to 2.5 years, that is the adolescent growth phase. So what exactly is the importance of these growth spurts in orthodontics? So growth spurts can be utilized to increase or decrease the growth of bones. For example, we can take an example of chin cup. Chin cup is an appliance which is used to restrict the mandibular growth. Okay, so mandibular growth can be restricted, but the chin cup, where the class 3 malocclusion is being treated, should be utilized or should be applied during the growth spurt, where the active growth is happening, so we can restrict it. Similarly, the Frankel functional regulator is an appliance which is used in class 2. Class 2 is maxillary excess or mandibular deficiency. So it increases or it stimulates the growth of mandible. So this also can be used during the growth spurts and utilize the potential of increased growth. So chin cup and Frankel functional regulator is used for class 3 and class 2 malocclusions respectively. And we should always make sure that the patient wears the appliance till the cessation of that growth spurt happens. So till the growth spurt is getting over, we need to keep on advising the patient to wear this, otherwise there will be relapse. Because if we stop the usage of these appliances, the growth will be happening and there will be a bad result or a unstable result. So that should be kept in mind. And also one more thing is that we need to keep the growth spurt in mind before doing, that is exactly on a female and a male patient. We need to have a clear-cut idea about the growth spurt period when doing the treatment on boys and girls. And next thing is the expansion of dental arches, that is a rapid maxillary expansion, which responds well during this adolescent growth spurts, and the results are more likely to be stable. So when we are doing a rapid maxillary expansion, we should always do it on the adolescent growth spurt, so we'll get a better, a stable result. And certain patient with gross skeletal discrepancies may require orthognathic surgical correction, and surgery is best carried out after the cessation of active growth. So in such a scenario, we need to wait for the growth spurts to get over. So once the active growth is stopped, we can go for an orthognathic surgery. So this was the importance of growth spurts in orthodontic treatment. So we have three growth spurts: infantile, mixed dentition, and adolescent growth spurts. And the years, that is up to 3 years, mixed dentition or juvenile is 7 to 9 and 8 to 11, adolescent is 10 to 12 and 12 to 14 years, and its uses in orthodontic treatment. Hope you understood the concept of growth spurts. I'll come up with a new topic in orthodontics. Thank you.